Hello, slime lovers. Y'all know what time it is? It's slime time, y'all. Welcome to the slime show.
That is a time.
Slime up, y'all.
Fish on.
Brought to you by Carolina Lake Weights. Come drift with us.
No catfish ain't expensive, but it needs to be free. Some folks crazy about it, others have to leave it be. You walk down to the bank so you can flash your way. You're looking for
fish on. Yeehaw, baby. What's up, slime lovers? I'm your host, Chris, a.k.a. El Gato Azul. These are my partners in slime over here. Jamie and Rebecca, the Carolina Real Screamers. And we've got some special guests today. Swamp Donkey, one of our Carolina Lake Weights pro staffers, Russell Rhodes. And Ken and Alicia Ferguson from Profound Fishing, also our Carolina Lake Weights pro staffers. Welcome to the show, guys.
Welcome, everybody.
Woo-woo! Let's do this.
So tonight's topic, we're going to be talking about stranger things on the water and fun fishing stories. We're going to have some of our other pro staff come in probably a little bit later. We've got, I think, Gerald Wyatt's supposed to stop in, Josh Wick, Ryan Bortz, possibly Jeremy Eads. His son's graduating. I'm not sure what he's graduating. He's a little guy. So, Jamie, do you know?
I believe he's, I don't know. I don't know. Jeremy told me, I forgot. Sorry, buddy. I can't remember yesterday.
Hopefully those guys will come in at some point and help us with the show. But before we get started, we'll say hello to chat. Let's see who all is in here. Tonight we got 351 Cleveland. We got Bend and Tips Catfishing. That's one of our new sponsored anglers for Carolina Lake Weights. Facebook user, what's up, guys? I can't see who that is, but what's up, buddy? Straight Getting Fishing. They're here for Ken and Alicia. Welcome. We got Tech and Tackle TV. What's up? Robert Lipton, or Linton. I call him Lipton. Lip, they call him Lib. He's another one of our Carolina Lake Weights teammates. We got Misplaced Fishing. We got Paul with P&B Catfishing. What's up, Paul?
What's up,
we got Danimal. My boy Dan's in the house. What's up, Dan? Jonathan Zuck. Indiana Chris. We got Chris Usselton in the house. What's up, Chris? Got another Chris. Chris Everett. Welcome to the Slime Show. Another Facebook user. Can't see the Facebook users, sorry guys, we're on a YouTube platform, so we can't see who y'all are. Another Facebook user, Dave Garcher. What's up, Dave? Welcome to the show, buddy. Uncle Lou, welcome in, partner.
What's up, Uncle Lou?
So, we got 33 people in here. That's awesome. We appreciate everybody coming in. It's a new show, the Slime Show, Next Level Catfishing. We're going to be talking catfishing with industry insiders, pro staffers, company owners, and just people that are in kind of in the know. So anything you guys got going on this this past week, news-wise?
Well, Rebecca's cranking out a bunch of new hats from the Carolina Lake Weights.
Woo! They go so fast. Every time I stick them on the internet, they're gone.
Yeah, I've actually got some photos I can post up of those.
Woo!
Look at all those pretty hats.
You know I love that green.
Oh, yeah.
I want one of those Real Men Dig Big Kidneys. I want the CLW with the fish as the C. And I want one of those new ones you put up. I love this one right here.
Hustlers, gotta have
those. I gotta get one. I want one of those too. So
she was thinking about me when she put that up with the big muscles.
Hey, those are mine. Those are mine.
Yeah, I just told a lie right on TV.
Go ahead and get me set up with a care package.
Absolutely.
So we also got some new guys that came on that are going to be selling the weights. Last week we got Dale's Tackle, which is awesome. We're going to be working with Dale kind of hand in hand. We're going to help promote each other. He's going to carry our weights. Ken and Alicia is pretty much who we got to try to set that deal up. So appreciate that, Ken and Alicia. How did you guys get on with Dale?
Well, kind of the same way that we got in contact with y'all. We made a post, hey, we need some new fishing hooks because we kept bending hooks. So made a post like that, and that's how we met Dale. Remember?
Yeah, you get tired of losing fish after a while.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's pretty much, he's a good guy. He called us right off the bat, and he said, let me send you something to try out. And if you like it, I'll know. And then, of course, we were placing more orders within a few days.
Yeah.
I've dealt with Dale over the years. He's always had really good hooks. But he's got a good reputation of just being a good dude. And that's one of the reasons I wanted to try to get you guys to facilitate that deal with Carolina Lake Weights. So I appreciate that. I don't know where it'll lead, but, you know, partnerships are cool. And I like having strong teammates. So,
right.
We got hooks and hammocks in the house. Carolina Real Screamers. Hey, what's up? We got Whisker Dreams. What's up, buddy? Welcome in. Catfish Regulators. All right. Appreciate everybody stopping in and at least checking us out for a little bit. Hopefully we'll have some fun tonight. What else? You got a new tackle company too, right, Jamie?
Yeah, we were able Sunday afternoon. We also added another bait company to the family, Hook, Line, and Sinker out of Lumberton, North Carolina.
Mr. Billy owns it. He is amazing. So if you guys ever go by Lumberton, stop by and say hi.
All right.
Yes.
Awesomeness.
So that takes us up to now with Dale's and that 17 different locations now.
So what's up, Kevin? What's up, Trinity? Welcome in, boys. A couple more Facebook users in as well. Off the Hook. Welcome, buddy.
Palmetto, thank you so much, Chris. Did you
check
see
that out, Chris.
Palmetto with a...
Hey, thanks, buddy. Appreciate that. Getting rich.
Thank you, buddy.
Appreciate you, Kevin. That's awesome, man. So, you know, Kevin's been good to me. He's had me on his show a few times. Really good dude. You know, I can go down this list. Pretty much everybody in here has become I've become friends with. JBN, he's one of my Mad Cats teammates. He's in here. Appreciate you stopping in, buddy. Yeah, YouTube will make you rich unless you catfish.
Oh, my gosh. That's a good one.
Hey, catfishing is an expensive sport now.
That is.
I was a millionaire before I started catfishing, and now I'm broke.
Join the crowd.
As like earlier, Rebecca posted a hat, and before I could click order, it was gone.
I know. I need to have a couple on there before I do it. I put four, and they just went wham, done.
I know. now Mad Cat's coming out with a new rod. And before I even had it in my hand, I'm like, I gotta have it. I'm gonna get a whole set of them. I got three sets of rods already. Mad Cats.
I'm gonna have to order 10 more.
What did you do?
More.
You bought 5 and 5. Oh my gosh.
Yes, got 10 more now. We got to get more.
Yeah, Palmetto says the YouTube profits has allowed him to get the dollar menu from McDonald's.
That's how you're doing good.
You're big timing it, buddy. Yeah, Ben and Tips. We put him on sponsored angler team a couple days ago. He said he's going to get him six of those rides. Join the club, buddy. I think they're going to be sold out the first day.
Oh, absolutely. There's no way it's not going to be, because I know I'm going to be there. Getting 10.
Yeah, I'm sending Rebecca up to that morning to pick up 10 or 15 of them.
Dang. I saw Ken and Alicia said, we got 20 rods for sale. We're making room for some new ones.
They all gone.
They're already sold.
They just waiting on me to say, come get them.
Swamp Donkey's got like 30 rods.
Hey,
how are you going to justify that to your wife?
Hey, we got 22 of them. I need some more, though. I think I can put like 32 rod holders around the boat.
If you got 32 rod holders and that many hooks in the water, you don't even need bait. Anything that swims under there.
I'm going to throw the trolling motor out, and we're just going to snag everything up the river.
Sounds like somebody else I know.
We got straight fishing. Look at there.
Jerry Parker, boy, he freaking nailed a giant. Did y'all see that fish he caught?
Not yet, I have.
I don't think so.
Oh, man. Catfish regulators, appreciate that, buddy. That's awesome. Yeah, Jerry, he got like an 84 or something out of the Mississippi River a couple of days ago.
Oh, yeah.
God almighty. He couldn't even hardly lift that thing up. Yeah, I get envious this time of year because our lake big fish dry up right about now. It's you can still get one, but they're hard to target. And then these river guys just start freaking hammering them. I'm like,
it's our turn.
It's our turn. It's time to start slinging.
We won't even have a chance. Probably right around June 1st, it's over. And then we don't even really have a shot at a big blue until probably right around the middle of July. They'll come off their nests. And then you got to go at night because big fish, they go nocturnal in Texas during the summer. So.
You know, we're strictly nighttime now, buddy. We're gonna tear them up.
Ugh. Yeah.
Yeah, it's so hot here. We're fixing to go nocturnal too.
Yep. Got to same. And get beat up by the mayflies.
Oh yeah. Ugh.
That tournament this past weekend was tough, man. We caught so many dinks it wasn't funny. Three fish, 64 pounds won the tournament.
Really?
Yeah.
Three fish, 64 pounds. That sounds about right for our time of year here. I mean, that'd be a pretty good bag, really. I mean,
three. Man, it was tough.
Yeah, but y'all's rivers should take off now, right?
Heck yeah.
This weekend, we're definitely going to hopefully throw out some big ones. I won't say where we're going, but we're definitely going to take some video.
Hey, where are you going, Jamie? I plan on being there Saturday night.
No, we got a little secret place we're going to go to.
We're going to walk right to the walk-em-off.
Uh-huh.
Walk-em-off Outfitters put in right there.
Freddie asked if y'all are coming to Tillery this weekend.
We were actually planning on going to Tillery, but I had the date wrong. Thought it was Saturday night. It's Friday night. They will not let me off of work, unfortunately. So everybody on Tillery is safe this weekend. So So, no, we would want to go, but they won't let me off of work to come and fish that tournament.
That's going to be a bunch of Mad Catters in that one.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
That's the heart of Mad Cat country up in there.
Yeah, that tournament's actually growing real big, man. I wish it was on Saturday night, but unfortunately it's on Friday night.
Lynn said, make more hats. He goes, by the time I got there, they were gone. I after the show, I'm getting back to work.
Hey, you just have to become sick Friday morning.
Yeah.
Jamie don't know what sick is.
Straight getting fishing, said Ken and Alicia, I will be at the dam on Belton. Laughing emoji. Oh, they left. Ken and Alicia are out of here.
They've been having
tech. They went fishing. They got excited.
Yeah, I found out earlier when I tried to order that hat that Tammy had ordered some.
She did.
Yeah.
We wasn't saying nothing.
Nope.
Ken and Alicia, straight getting fishing, said he will be at the dam on Belton. Laughing emoji. What does that mean?
I mean, everybody says that there's a catfish as big as a Volkswagen by the dam. Yeah. You know how it is.
Yeah. That's the everybody says go to the dam when they don't tell you their spots or where they really actually go.
To go to the
but
dam.
The funny thing is, mine and her first place we ever went fishing together at
was near the dam.
Was near the dam, and we can go there any time of the summer at nighttime and catch 15 or 20 fish. I mean, nice. It's not a bad spot. It's just you got
to
hit.
Yeah,
it
they like those right rocks, and it's close to deep water, and it's a good transition. That's pretty
exactly.
much it. I mean, fish like that.
Oh yeah,
When I tell guys, man, I just wish we could catch big fish in the middle of summer, they're like, why can't you? They fish got to eat. And I'm like, if you could do it, somebody in Texas would have figured it out in the last 40 years. It just, it doesn't happen. And he said, well, why don't you just go to the deepest part of the lake and just fish that deepest hole? And I'm like, you don't understand what a thermocline is, buddy, because that's dead man's land. There is not a fish down there. So,
yeah.
Lee Evans says, who is this and where am I?
Welcome home.
Welcome, Lee.
Welcome home.
I love that. Who is this?
Get right in, Lee.
Sorry.
New phone, who this?
Who it is?
You said Ryan.
Facebook user says, Rebecca, glad you're feeling good enough to be on cam.
Oh my gosh. I'm telling you, if I could just get this straight now, it's craziness.
So, for those that weren't here last week, Rebecca was in a major car wreck. She got into a head on collision. Seatbelt or airbag did not deploy. Got hit by another car going, the other car is going, I think, 55, something insane.
It was a mess. It was a big mess. So
she still got a hard head, so she's good to go.
It didn't hit my soft spot. No.
She's been hanging around you too long, Jamie.
I'm telling you.
She's too mean.
I believe it.
I didn't say that.
But other than that, I mean, I'm feeling okay. Just that knee. I'm like, oh gosh, I can't wait for this to be over.
No whiplash?
It was horrible. It's horrible. Everybody says your neck. It's between my shoulder blades. It's like, my God, it's horrible. So it would be nice to walk around. So this weekend we're going fishing and literally I can't do anything but just sit there. And I'm like, God, you're going to have to put some rods beside the boat for me. I'm like, oh, it's craziness. It's hard relying on him. He wants everything to himself.
You might have to let him catch a fish.
No.
No joke.
I'm going to have to bring the kids. Give me that rod.
I won't holler fish on. I promise you that.
I can't see. Oh, God.
So tonight's topic of the show is going to be stranger things on the water and fun fishing stories. I know you guys have had to see some strange things on the water. Let's start with Ken and Alicia. What's something strange you guys have seen while fishing or just being on the water?
Well, we thought it was strange. We're not much to being on the river, so we had no idea when it's going to rise and when to be looking for it to rise or fall, because we ain't getting no rain. We didn't know 5 hours away was really affecting us that night that we're coming down there. So we go down on the Brazos a couple of times every now and then. And so one time we had a little John boat that get in the shallow so we could drop it. And we went down and about right at dark and started fishing. And
we started setting up to fish.
Yeah. And she said, "I think the boat's getting in the water." I said, "No, I pulled it all the way up." I literally took the little 5-horsepower motor and set it in the boat and pulled it all the way out of the water. "It's no way." She said, "No, it looks like it's getting closer to the boat." And I was like, "No." And then where we had our pole set out started going up like 6-7 inches into the water. And I was like, "Something." And then all of a sudden, here comes our boat. And it's going right past us in the river.
I remember baiting the hook, and I just look up at our boats, just like, and I said, "That's our boat."
So I guess we kind of thought that was strange, and some people probably would think that's ridiculous, but we don't know much about the river fishing, so that was something new for us to learn. Is when the river was coming up because it rained above us the day before, and they were letting out of Lake Whitney, and here comes the water, and they come up about 3 foot overnight, and we're sitting on a little beachy area, and it's starting to fill up with water. Kind of creepy.
Hey, we just moved everything back and kept fishing. As the water rose, moved all back.
Start wade fishing.
Oh, yeah.
Straight Getting Fishing said, "Ken, tell them about my PB with the broken reel."
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, this was just about a month ago. He said, "I want to catch my PB, and I'm tired of waiting." And I said, "Well, we're going to do it tonight. It's going to happen." So we go out, and we're just talking a bunch of junk, having a good time. And about 20 fish later, it's starting to get pretty late, and everything kind of calmed down. It got real quiet, and there was no wind on the water, about 2 foot of water. And the pole behind us to the left, I'm talking slam so hard. I've not seen one slam so hard in my life. And the reel goes flying in the air. And oh, he's God. Holding the reel, and I'm holding the rod, and we're fighting the fish. And all he's around. Going in circles around the boat like this. And we can't figure out what's going on, if we still even got the fish. But then we hear him splash, so we know we got the fish. And so we're trying to figure out how to put the reel back on until we realize when he bent the frame of the reel, and it wouldn't go back in and tighten down. So he's just got to hold the reel, and I'm helping pull the line up the rod, and he gets it. I thought it was going to be like a 60 or 70 the way he hit, and it ended up being like 36 pounds. So we were both kind of shocked it wasn't as big as it was, but it was still a good fish for somebody's PB.
PBs are always a good.
Oh, yeah.
Those are my favorite.
Yeah, we love PBs.
I love getting kids PBs.
Oh, yeah.
Love having kids on the boat because it's easy to get them a PB. You know, if they come in the winter on my boat, I generally can get them a PB.
I love putting Jamie on PB.
I was going to say I love watching.
You don't let Jamie catch fish. How the hell will he ever get a PB?
Chris, anytime I get like a 15-pounder, I got to give it to him.
Hey, Jamie's the anchor man.
He's hella good at running the grass.
That's right. That's right.
If she lets me. I'm just going to give her the keys to the boat and just start sitting back.
I need you to drive for just a little bit longer. I can't right now.
I've seen your driving.
You love it. That might be our funny story. No.
That might be a scary story.
Hey, it can't be no worse than Tammy Rhodes driving, I promise.
Nobody asked you.
Oh my God. Oops, that was not me.
I thought you had to sneak outside, Russell.
Yes, they followed me.
He must be sitting by the window.
So, yep. What kind of...
I can't go back in the house. I mean, I don't have to sit here and listen.
I love her.
So, what kind of strange things on the water have you seen, Russell?
Probably the strangest thing that I've seen. The river was coming up one day, a bunch of trash floating down. And so I'm riding wide open looking for logs. And ended up hitting a hog crossing the river.
Dang. I've seen a bunch of hogs crossing the lake.
All the time.
He finally got on the other side, and he was so out of breath, I thought he was going to just die right there. But he ended up living and walking off.
They're tough.
Strangest thing I've had happen on the river.
Yep, that's got me beat. I normally don't hit hogs on the river.
Hey, there was a guy behind me. He said, "You didn't see that hog?" I said, "No, I'm looking for logs, not hogs."
So. We get ambushed by hogs all the time.
Oh. Tammy says hi.
Hi, Tammy.
Oh, Lord.
I thought Russell was going to say me. Man,
I've seen deer crossing the lake. I've seen, about a dozen hogs crossing the lake, and not a little section of the lake, out in the freaking middle of the lake. I saw about a 12-point giant buck. I'm like, just hightailing it like an Olympic swimmer going across the lake. And I just like, what? And I was 10 feet from him, just motoring along, and he's just swimming, going.
Well, last year I was fishing and right beside a log jam and heard something just tearing up the bank, and ended up taking the anchor loose and going over there beside it. And there was a deer trying to get up the bank. And it seemed like as that deer was fighting through the vines, a gator just came up there and just grabbed him.
Damn. God.
I ain't want to fish where you fishing.
Yeah, you do. You park your boat right beside me. Come on, man.
You got to check your boat out.
I got to see where your fishing hole's at. Yeah, now yeah. I know it's on the farm now.
That was a good one. Oh, right on that 180 acres.
Hey, you need an anchor man Saturday night. Just let me know.
I might need one.
She's probably going to throw me out the boat.
This is Jamie. Don't throw it. Ease it down. I'm like, I'm trying. God.
10 feet later, if the anchor hits the water.
It's on the bottom. It's on the bottom.
Yeah, how about you? Carolina Real Screamers, what kind of strange things you guys seen?
This won't be a book.
Okay, you guys ready? What do you want to tell it? Which one?
Go ahead, tell them about the traps.
You want to do the one with Blake? So we went fishing and we made Blake, our oldest kid, come with us. Now he's 22, so he's like, I don't want to hang out with you guys anymore. I got my own boat. So we made him come. Handcuffed him and everything. No. So we brought him to the river and literally told him, look, cool stuff happens. This river's haunted. So wait, just wait. And he's like, yeah, right. Whatever, whatever, whatever. Well, we're fishing by a bridge.
Well, a railroad track.
A railroad bridge. Track. A trestle area thing. And
the thing that doot, goes back. Train.
Just back. So it got dark. And then
no way. Really?
It got dark. And then all of a sudden somebody just starts walking across the bridge holding a lantern. And we were both sitting there like, wait, what?
True story.
That boy almost walked off that boat. I was like, oh my God.
Redneck come out the woods fishing off the train trestle.
And he was yelling.
This dude was making some noises.
So it turns out it was haunted.
Yeah. I don't know what he was fishing for, but I know what he was drinking.
It was awesome. That was the best night. This is about as weird as it gets for us.
Okay.
I've seen a ton of strange things on the water. One of the probably strangest things I've seen is I had about a 40-pound blue puke up a cormorant on the deck of my boat. And the thing was half the size. I mean, it was a big cormorant. They're big. It had eaten a cormorant and puked it up on the deck of my boat.
Golly.
Oh, my God.
Now, I've seen them throw up weird stuff. Like, I had one puke up like 100 ladybugs one time. I'm like, where do you find 100 ladybugs? You know, clams and weird stuff like that. But that cormorant was shocking to see him throw those up. But I've seen giant blues during the springtime, during the threadfin spawn. I've seen them beach themselves on the shore trying to eat an egret. So I know they like birds. I've seen them crush baby ducks that are swimming around in the shallows. So those, I like fishing shallow in the spring because it's always like National Geographic. You never know what you're going to see up shallow.
You know, I love when you're out there after a tournament or after a fishing trip that night, looking in there and just seeing what's in the live wire after, you know, you take your fish out.
Clam City.
Uh-oh. We lose Chris. Hello.
It looks like we lost him.
Oh, he's back.
He's back.
Yeehaw, baby. Charlie Rhodes in the house. What's up, young man?
What's up, buddy?
So that's some strange stuff I've seen on the water. Deer crossing, pigs, and weird animals being puked up.
Coyotes coming about.
Yeah, I look, like I said, man, whatever, it's weird looking that live where you see in mussels, you see in crawdads. I mean, they ain't no telling what you're going to see.
Right.
I've seen them throw up 5 or 6 sand bass that are about 10 inches long, big blues in the winter. You know, they'll puke up just a big old sand bass, but like 5 of them. Like, well, yep. I know what they're eating. That's magic bait.
That's right.
So let's move on to fun fishing stories. Ken and Alicia, you guys got any fun fishing stories? No, y'all got to have some with all those kids.
Yeah. It's always fun being on the water. So every trip out there is fun.
That's definitely true.
But the funnest part is watching the kids get on the fish. Our kids or somebody else's kids, just seeing them catch fish and their face light up and seeing them, just that addiction taking over.
Yeah.
It's the real deal. That's probably the funnest thing you'll ever do. Watching my kids, you know, in general, watching them go from catching some small little bluegill to a bass here and there and catching a little small little eater size catfish to it's time for y'all to step it up and they start catching 20 and 30s. That's pretty entertaining to watch them fight one and watch them help each other with the net and all, because we let them do it all. They net it and everything. And so that's pretty fun. And then, but the funnest I think was, we was on Lake Waco a few months back and we had caught several, you know, in the teens and a couple in the 20s, I believe. I think we had caught 130 that day, but the twins doubled up on two fish that could have been twins that were in the 20s. And so they're both fighting a fish, so they couldn't be a net person for each other. So we had to help them out. And that was pretty fun.
I didn't know who to record. One was on the front of the boat, one was on the back.
That's where you want to slide them close together.
Yeah.
Well, and Desi, when like what, a year ago, she wouldn't even touch a fish. She, I have a video on my phone. I remember.
Yeah, she said, no, I'm not touching it.
It was her first fish. And was it a flathead or a blue? I think it was a flathead.
No, it was a blue.
It was a blue. And I said, it's your first catfish. You want to hold it? And she turned around so quick. No. Just like that. Like, that was horrible that I even told her to hold it. Now she'll throw it over her shoulder. She don't care if slime gets in her hair. She's all over it.
Our youngest two kids, we decided it was time for them to catch big fish when we seen Action Jackson catching big fish.
Yeah.
We said, if he can do it, there's got to be a technique for a younger kid to be able to actually haul in a bigger fish. And so we watched some of your videos, and we seen that he was kind of holding it between his legs a little bit to reel down.
Yeah.
So that's what we did with them, and they were able. That's how Allie got hers last week, or was it the week before last. And it was how big was that one? 15 or so. For a 4-year old, it's pretty good.
I think it was 15. Four.
Yeah, that's really good. You know, we have a lot of kids on the boat, and I've always, my friends who've had similar age kids as Jackson have always come along with us. And at four, most kids can't catch a fish. It's the dexterity of the reel and all that. They pinch their fingers and, you know, but if you let them start on a little one and then you work your way up, eventually they get one. When they're little, a 3-pounder is like fighting a monster.
Yeah.
And it's just like an epic battle, every fish. That's why I loved taking my son. And he wouldn't just catch them all day, but, you know, he'd catch a handful out of the 30 eaters we'd catch. And we just kind of brought him along that way. And I think when he was 3, he got a 20-pounder, which it swam straight to the boat. Everything was just perfect for him, and he got it. But it took him a whole year before he really got beyond that 20. And you know, when he was almost about to turn 5, he got a 44, and which I couldn't believe it. Now, my buddy helped him because he just, that rod, he couldn't fight it. So my buddy held onto the rod and just, he cranked it. But that to me was probably one of the coolest things I'd ever seen, is seeing that little kid catch that giant fish. It outweighed him.
That's crazy.
But after that, I thought, you got to leave it in the rod holder for these big ones. So I leave it in the rod holder, and he can't control it. It gets hung up on all the other crap. But I don't care, as long as he gets to get that one. And it's a progression, you know. Now he's 7, and he's reeling in 80s. And I can't believe he got that 80.
Oh, my gosh, yes. Yeah.
I didn't know what he had. I didn't know it was an 80. I thought it was a 40, because that's in the video. I'm like, I think you might have the junior lake record. And little did I know, it doubled the junior lake record. It's like when he got it up next to the boat, I saw that. I looked in that fish's eyes and I was like, oh my God. I can't believe you got this fish. So I'm with you guys on the fishing with the kids. To me, it doesn't get any better than that, really.
Chris, it looks like we've got one backstage back there also.
It says Bortz is backstage. He is not backstage.
He has disappeared.
He's like, he gone.
He's out of here.
He went fishing too.
Texas boy catfishing. How are ya?
So, you know, when Jackson turned, I'd say, so now he's 7. When he was 5, he started catching big fish on his own without any help from dad. But the biggest that he could get was a 40. And that was the end of that year. And then all of last year, he probably caught 5 40s. I was wanting to get him the 50. I wanted to get him that junior lake record. And we just, it never worked out. Somebody else would grab the rod, and he wouldn't. He was good for about one big fish per trip, and then he would be gassed. But this year, when he turned, he was 6 in the winter. This year, he was able to catch as many fish as I could hand him the rod. He would catch them all day long. He'd catch 3 or 4 40s. He'd get him a 50. And I mean, it was just awesome. So I'd say this year was my funnest year of fishing by a long shot, just because of him.
He had a heck of a year, that's for sure. Looks like all the kids is out doing all the parents year.
Absolutely.
I'm fine with it. I like it.
That's the way it's supposed to be.
My buddies are like, I can't believe you hand him the rod on a 50. Right. I'd want to reel that in. And I'm like, I get more joy out of watching him back.
Yeah,
exactly.
It don't feel the same when you pull it in versus a kid pulling it in.
Yeah.
That's
it.
Yeah, I just throw the rods out. Charlie grabs them.
That's right.
Yeah, see, I'll just say fish on. Jackson comes and jumps on it. So, yeah, I don't force him to sit there and watch the rods like a man. I let him play with his dog. And when y'all saw last trip, he's out in the water swimming with his dog while I'm reeling in fish. So, I just want him to have fun. So,
I might try that one this weekend.
Look,
yeah, I might as well swim while you fish.
I'm out.
I'd say probably one of my funnest trips was this October when he hooked into the 55 and the rod went overboard.
And that was crazy.
He started crying, you know, because he knows how much I love my Mad Catz rods. He's, I'm sorry, Dad. I'm sorry. I said, man, don't be sorry. We're going to get this fish.
Almost jumped over. I think he's frozen.
He froze.
Chris nearly jumped over the boat. And the whole time we were watching it, we were like, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. I was like, oh, my
I'm
God.
I'm back.
I was reiterating. We should have all been froze.
Yeah, but that rod went overboard, and he was upset big time. And I looked down. I almost dove in. We were in 4 foot of water. We were dragging. And I was about to dive in after that sucker. But I saw that Parks planer board float. And I'm like,
yeah.
I got off the gunnel and I grabbed that Parks. I threw it in reverse, grabbed Parks, pulled the rod up, handed him the rod. He got the fish in, got a junior leg record. That was the funnest fish fight that I've ever seen.
Y'all have to be sitting in the middle of wintertime watching this.
Yeah, that was exciting.
It was crazy. We even had fish on our line and we didn't even know it because we were stuck watching. We were like, oh my God, it was crazy. Who we got? Shad Daddy, how you doing?
Shad Daddy, 922 Crappie Barbecue. We got Tim Molina. Welcome in, boys. We got Texas Boys Catfishing. We got Josh from Nebraska Mad Catter. We got another Facebook user. Can't see who that is. Don R. Welcome in, Don. We've got a nice little crowd hanging with us. Appreciate all you guys. Palmetto, we'll see you, buddy. Appreciate you stopping in.
Thank you, Kevin.
So, I could tell a million fun fishing stories, but anybody else want to tell another one?
I got a funny story that happened to me and Charlie. A few years ago, we were in a tournament, and Charlie was young, so it was a daytime tournament. He fell asleep on the boat. Almost time the tournament was over. And fish was on. He wouldn't wake up. So I grabbed the rod, and I start hollering at Charlie to grab the net, grab the net. I look up there, and I got my anchor hooked to the pedestal on the front seat. And he reaches up there and grabs the front seat and takes it loose. Sound asleep. And I told him, don't turn the seat loose now. I said, I need you to grab the net, not the seat. And he finally woke up from it and ended up winning the tournament with that one fish.
Yeah. Good job, buddy.
Yeah, anytime you fall asleep, that's when you're going to win a tournament. That was to us all the time.
I try to get her sleep more often.
He brings me a pillow.
It's quiet.
But yeah, last year that one night we pulled in 34 fish that night. That was crazy.
Charlie, remember that one.
Every 5-10 minutes I tell Charlie, hey, if they don't bite, we're fixing to move and another rod would go down. Another rod would go down. We caught 28 in one hole. But we ended up second in that one.
Thanks, Kevin.
Appreciate you, Kevin. So some of my buddies are in here. Santa, I don't know, some of y'all may have seen us live stream in the winter with my boy Chris. He looks like Santa. His boat, he calls Santa Sleigh. And he dresses up as Santa Claus around Christmas and takes my son fishing. So what's up, Santa? Welcome in. Another buddy of mine, Jeff Martin. He's another local guy from around here. My fishing buddy, he's been on the boat. And he's on fire this last year. He finally got these big fish figured out. So welcome in, buddy. We appreciate you, Kevin. Yeah, we got a lot of young kids that come on our boat and break those PBs. So to me, those PB trips, I think, are probably the coolest thing you can do on a boat. Because I know they're life-changing. When you catch a big catfish, if you've not caught one before, it's something that you'll never forget. Even when you're old, I still remember when I was little, I remember every big fish I caught, every one of them. So I try to pay that type of memory forward for kids. And I try to encourage others to do the same. That's why I think it's cool that Carolina Lake Weights does the Junior Angler of the Week, or the Kid of the Week. We got a Junior Angler Pro Staff we try to get them to be an inspiration for other kids and for dads to take their kids to go fishing. So, well, big reason I brought Ken and Alicia onto the team. Big reason we got Russell on the team. He fishes tournaments with his son. So I know Ken and Alicia got multiple rugrats they bring fishing. So I'm hoping we can get them on our team at some point. I know he fishes for money. So sometimes it's hard to take the kids when you got to try to make a living from fishing. But they seem to find time to always fish together. So I think that's cool.
I tell you, man, that is awesome that, you know, the parents out there, you know, get your kids out there and go fish and make memories. That's definitely what it's about, man.
Yeah.
Right.
I know when we show up at boat landing, we take our kids, we pull up, the bus pulls back up behind us.
Okay.
So in our 7-head, they'll get off and go with us. Yeah. It's more like a family reunion that day. We come home, I'm bald, you know.
I ain't taking my hat off.
I'm done with you.
That's what it's about, man. Having fun, making memories, and when it's tournament time, getting serious and going after some big ones, that's what else we enjoy and what drives us to keep on trucking.
Yep.
I think that's cool. I hope you guys will get to do some more fishing. I know y'all been busy as hell the last year, which, you know, that's part of what y'all signed up for, but.
Yep.
No, we wouldn't have it no other way.
We wouldn't have it no other way. Once we get this, get everything up and running 100%, we're definitely going to be back, and we're going to be coming back stronger than ever.
Y'all got tournaments already planned out. I know y'all got y'all's this weekend coming up. Y'all got canceled, but.
Yeah, I just fished one this past weekend up in the upstate this weekend. Supposed to fish one this weekend. I thought it was on Saturday night, but it's on Friday night. But we're going to probably have two or three a month starting next month. And plus, we're going to be putting on some coming up probably next weekend. I don't know yet, but we're probably gonna throw one next weekend. So stand by.
Next weekend?
Yeah.
We might throw one next weekend. So we got a lot of people asking us, and so we're gonna see about doing next weekend.
Where at next weekend?
Are you gonna be here next weekend?
It's gonna be a surprise. We're gonna pop it up right at last second. That way nobody's able to pre-fish. no one can go and look around, so we're going to pop it up probably on a Thursday night where it's going to be, I love, and fish it that Saturday night.
Hold up now. No. Somebody's going fishing this Saturday and then pop up a tournament next Saturday. No.
Listen, all I need you to do is sign your $100 bill. That's it. I'll add it to my collection.
Tammy said I can't donate any money.
I like how you just throw me into this under the bus. I had nothing to do with it.
We got David Smith. We got David Smith at the house and all.
Jamie.
What's up, David? Welcome in, buddy.
I got me a green hat.
Uh-huh. Look at
that. Swamp donkey.
There you go, buddy. You lost your hair like me.
Yeah, I lost it a long time ago, man.
Oh, my God.
You know, when you get married and have kids, the hair just disappears.
What?
You got pretty hair.
He won't take his hat off.
He don't want to put these boys to shame.
That's the next show, Chris. Men who lose their hair.
I still got all mine. So.
Oh, look at
her. Oh, there you go.
I feel you, buddy. I feel you down there.
I don't know how, because I got a son that'll make you pull your hair out.
Hey, my oldest son, he got a head full of hair like Rebecca and his mama.
Jake and Fisher said, why is everyone bald? Can't take your hat off.
Hey, I'm almost to the point to go on Amazon and get one of them palm shavers and just shave it bald.
That's what he
I was just
saying.
Talking about that the other day. I'm going to do it.
He said, I'm going to do it.
I'm going to do it now. Now that I just actually thought of it, I'm actually going to do it.
And I was going to go get me the visor that had the hair already made on it.
With the 4D part.
Hey, you can get a tattoo of the little man and a push mower up there on the head.
You guys are going to die next time the show comes on and Jamie's in his Amazon visor.
No,
I might even put Carolina Lake Weights on it.
All right, Chris, take us back to your show, buddy.
Well, 922 Crappie said he's 50, married with a grown girl, and still has a full head of hair. Now, I don't know. Having a girl would definitely probably make me bald, but
look, Jamie's trying to show his off more.
Jamie's feeling good now, isn't he?
He is. Yeah, ain't got nothing on me.
It's like, yeah, I'm feeling pretty good now.
Yep.
This Pepsi Cola's kicked in.
Oh man.
Tammy said Russell had pretty hair.
Oh my gosh.
Hey, I used to have a head full of hair.
I'm barring Rebecca.
Oh my gosh. I was looking down. I was like, my hair feels like it's coming down.
Don't tell her tonight, half of that's coming off.
Dang.
Oh no. No.
I'm going to send it to Rebecca. You watch me.
Hey, Rebecca, Tammy says she's going to send you a picture.
Oh, come on, send it. I might show it to everybody.
I ain't sending no pictures.
See if I can find that thing.
Yeah, you can't find that.
You got to go way back for that one, Tammy.
Why don't we do Angler Kid of the Week? Let's Carolina Lake Weights Angler Kid of the Week. Today's show is brought to you by Carolina Lake Weights. Come drift with us at www.carolinalakeweights.com. So for guys that don't really know about the Carolina Lake Weights Kid of the Week, we do a spotlight each week on a kid that, you know, it could be a kid that's catching a lot of fish or just caught a really big fish, or could be just a cool fish picture. we post up, we have everybody post their picks up on our Carolina Lake Weights Facebook group, and then everybody gives thumbs up on whichever post they like, and we try to get a new kid in each week, but we also try to get the one who gets the most votes for the week. 2 weeks ago, Ken and Alicia's kids Devin and Desi won, and last week their other kid won. So congratulations to Allie. That is what about as cool of a fish pick as you'll ever see right there.
Yeah, that's a good picture right there.
We love that, man. That's what it is about right there.
So tell us about the fish, Alicia, and tell us about Allie a little bit.
Well, Ken had Allie on the boat on Daddy. That day. Daddy, it was Daddy.
Daddy's in that one.
Allie's, she's four. She's going to be five in September. She's always been into fishing just because she's been kind of brought around it since she was one. She used to go with Ken, like to go catch bait, and she would freak out when he would pull bait in, wanting to take the shad and put it in the bucket and all that stuff. So she's been really into it for a while, but we haven't really let her catch much until a little recently because she's all over the place. But yeah,
I know all about that.
Yeah, so he took her on that day, so I'm not sure about the story.
With that one, actually, the kids were taking turns. The next one that hit, it would be one of them's turn, and I just sat back. They were starting to bait their own hooks. All I did was cast it out sometimes. My son's gotten really good at casting on his own, so I can literally just dry the boat, anchor down, whatever I'm doing, and just sit back. And they'll double up sometimes with some eaters. You know, it's fun to watch them up there just reeling in fish. And they were, I think they were about 27, 28 fish into it in 4 hours. And they were just, I'm talking about, they were on the fish. And I think it was my oldest daughter, Desi's turn to catch the next fish. And when it hit, she went to grab the pole and she reeled down and she stopped. And she looked back at Allie and said, "It's your turn. You come get this fish," because she knew it was a bigger fish. And they wanted to see her catch a big fish because she's the only one that had yet to break in, you know, into the teens. And so they let her reel that one in, and they started video, and it actually got the video, a little bit of the video. And she struggled for a minute, and it was still a little tough, but she left it in the rod holder too long. So when it got by the boat and started going up under the boat, you can't get the rod holder out of the rod holder. And so it was kind of a mess for a minute. And then finally it gave up and just kind of come up to the surface, and we netted it. But she was excited as a kid could be, you know, at her age. I mean,
she kept saying, Desi, my fish.
No, she kept saying, "Check out my flatty."
Oh, yeah.
She just likes the flatty. That's not a flathead, but she calls it a flathead. I don't know why.
I love it, man. Love that.
Yeah, that's a cool picture. That fish is as big as her. I love that picture. Yeah, you know, my son's seven, and no matter however many thousands of fishes he's caught, he still reels them all the way up to the dang boat. And even when he's got a monster, I'm like, "Jackson, how many times are you gonna do this, man? You got to take the rod out of the rod holder sooner." But it is what it is. He'll get it figured out one of these days.
You know, we love watching the kids, man, you know, catch the fish. That's just making, you know, put a smile on your face. And, you know, just watching the parents, watching them kids catch them, it's just unbelievable. Something you'll never forget, that's for sure.
Yeah, I think fishing with the kiddos is as cool as it gets. I like it when my son has a friend on the boat, and it's just like, you know, Dan's got a son, Danimals Creations. He's got a son that's a year younger than Jackson, and they get along real good. So Dan comes fishing with us a couple times a year, but it's usually within the warm months and we're not really on big fish. But this past winter I said, "Dan, you guys got to come in the winter, and you got to come when I say. So he said, well, I'm a little more flexible this winter, so you just let me know. So when it came time, I said, come on, and they came, and we got Dan a 52, and we got his son a 35, 34. The biggest fish the kid had ever caught was a 2-pounder. So going from 2 to 34, man, it was epic. And we doubled up on him and Jackson doubled up on big fish. So we got to each, they got, you know, Jackson had like a 40 something and Dominic had his 34, and we got pictures of both the kids holding their fish, which it's just awesome when you can do that. God seems to be on your side when you got kids with you. Yep. I don't know what it is. He'll put two fish in the boat if you got two kids in the boat. I don't know. It's just kind of a blessing to have kids on the boat. So
I enjoy it when Rebecca allows me to catch a 25 or a 24 pounder. I'm like, yes, she did it. She let me get one. Thank God.
Rebecca's like another 20. You get this one.
So I know how it feels. I'm like a kid, man. I'm like, yes.
The rod goes down, and Jamie's like, what do I do now? Go get it.
You were talking about keeping that rod in the rod holder. I'm back there. I'm just cranking down on it. I kind of forgot how to take you out the rod holder. And
and you got to net it, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I guess spotlight of the week is for the anglers. We got three new anglers that we brought onto our sponsored angler team this past few days, actually. We got Patrick Gilliland. He's with Ben and Tips Catfishing. He's an angler out of North Texas. Actually, he might be an Oklahoman, but I won't hold that against him. He fishes a lot of our local tournaments. He's got a YouTube channel called Bending Tips Catfish. He's just a really good dude. He's been using Carolina Lake Weights. He's been continuously posting fish picks every week. He's very active angler, which, you know, I think is important if you're going to be doing this kind of thing. But there's Patrick. He got his new PB flathead last week, 40-something pound flathead. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
The day we brought him on, he's like, I'm about to go fishing, and he got his PB. So kudos to you, Patrick. We're glad to have you on the team, buddy. We got another angler that I met at CatCon, Randall Jeffries. He's got a YouTube channel called Trinity Outdoors. Constantly on the water, puts in a ton of work fishing. He's got a little YouTube channel called Trinity Outdoors. He's been using Carolina Lake Weights. He always spotlights Carolina Lake Weights in all of his fishing posts. So, when I spoke with him at CatCon, he had asked, how do I get on the team? I said, well, we're always looking for new guys. We want guys that are loyal to the brand. We really like guys that are active and that will, you know, who will engage our customers, but also our other team members. He's been willing to do that since day one. So, you know, I invited him onto the team. So welcome to the team, buddy. Nice. We're glad to have you. The third guy that we're bringing onto the team is John Ferguson. Now, he's one of my Mad Cats Pro Staff teammates. I think John's one of the best anglers in the country. He is a big fish freaking. I mean, the dude catches giant fish. He fishes up out of, I believe, Virginia. So he's around those big fish waters up there. He's been using Carolina Lake Weights and putting monsters in the boat with the products. So I knew when John started using Carolina Lake Weights, he would be a perfect fit for us. He's a really good dude, solid, solid guy. I know he's going to make a great teammate. I would imagine he's going to be on our pro staff really quick. It's just when you get an angler of his caliber, it's, an honor to have him on our team. So welcome to the team, John. I appreciate you accepting the invite, and we're glad to have you, man. So last week we kind of didn't really know what we were doing. We just kind of winged it. We never really got to answer questions from the audience. So if any of you got bending tips right there, 49 pounder was that flathead. So let me show you that picture one more time of Patrick's flathead. 50 pound flatty, PB. Congrats, buddy. That's awesome, man.
Nice so, fish.
Love all the different really colored neat. Flatheads on.
Yeah,
they are beautiful fish. With how ugly they are, they're just really interesting looking. Beautiful, really.
Beautiful.
But, you know, I like the big blue cat that's got the big bug eye and a ripped lip. Oh. And, you know, his one of his horns is snapped off. And I'm like, as banged up as he looks, like a pirate. And it was, a 12-aught hook hanging out his mouth. And
yeah, piercing.
Man, you are beautiful, buddy. I caught one of those black ones this winter. Now, it wasn't just one of those that goes up shallow and gets dark. It was, I don't know what they call it. It's not a piebald, but piebolic, or they have a name for it. It's a very rare kind of a sub-breed of, I don't know, breed might not be the right terminology. It's like not the same genetics as a regular blue cat. It's just a little bit different. It's like a piebald.
Yeah.
I caught one. It was black as night. It had the biggest bug eyes. It was just crazy looking catfish. That was the most beautiful fish that I'd seen this year. And my buddy's like, man, that thing's ugly. I'm like, that thing is beautiful. Look at his eyes. They're as big as mine. They're just crazy. I love holding that big fish up, and his eyeball is the same size as yours. It's like, you know you got a good one when his eyeball is like.
That's how Rebecca looks when she hooks into a big flathead. You're back there going, are they going to pop out?
Don't take your eye off of it. Don't take your eye off of it.
I ain't taking my eyes off of it.
What do they say? Your eyes get as big as our basketball.
I believe it.
Heck yeah.
You know, we got a lot of good people on our team, man. We're growing all the time, man. We got some of the best catfishermen and ladies on our team. I mean, it's just unbelievable.
Yeah, I'm glad we got Ken and Alicia. They are really awesome people, great teammates. They've really embraced our team as good as you could ask someone to be. I had a pretty good sense. Everybody we've brought on the team's been great.
That's it.
All the guys that all we brought onto the sponsored angler team, all different types of dudes and gals. But everybody jived well, you know, from all different walks of life. But we all are pretty passionate about catfishing.
Oh, yeah.
I like that Ken and Alicia are family fishing. I like that Russell's family fishing. I'm family fishing. You guys are family fishing. So.
Yeah.
That's it.
I think that's what sets Carolina Lake Weights apart from any other team. I think family is probably the first thing.
First.
It comes to mind when you think about Carolina Lake Weights. I tell guys when they come on our team, you're going to love this team, but it's really more like a family. Everybody's just different. We don't have all tournament anglers. We're not all we're all from different parts of the country. We're not all from South Carolina, North Carolina.
Texas.
We got Texas guys. We got Ohio guys.
We got Nebraska guys.
Nebraska, South Carolina, Virginia.
North Carolina. Wow.
We got them everywhere.
All over. And that's kind of, we designed it that way. Now, we didn't really know what we were doing, but It worked.
It worked. Chris, I believe Rebecca said the chat had a question.
Yeah.
So the question, I'll let you answer it. What started Carolina Lake Weights and what inspired y'all to do it?
Wow, that's easy.
The cool thing is, you know, like we've always made drifting weights, always, you know, and our friends would always come to us before tournaments and practice and go, I need drifting weights. And we were actually laying here one night, Jamie looked at me and he goes, look, go get a business license tomorrow. And I went, wait, what? I gotta go to work. And he was like, no, you're sick. Go get a business license. And I was like, okay. So I went and I got the business license. And I came home and I was like, did we mess up? This is crazy, you know? And it literally, we thought it would start out crawling, which our first month it did, you know? But after that, I mean.
It's amazing seeing where Carolina Lake Weights has started.
Yeah.
And where it's come to now. And I can tell you, we ain't slowing up. I mean, by no means. We're hoping this thing just completely. The family gets bigger, but you know, one thing that we always say in this, we can't do it without each and every one of you. Each and every one of you is what Carolina Lake Weights is all about. The hard work, you know, the sweat and everything. Y'all the ones behind or in that just makes it what it is. So we just, you know, lucky enough to have y'all as our family. Mm-hmm. And you know, it's just wonderful. So everything we do is just well worth it.
Yeah, I think Carolina Lake Weights is just really getting started.
I think when I met y'all last year, y'all just started the Lake Weights.
Yeah, we just started the business part of it. And, I mean, it just got crazy. You know, before we actually started the business, it just, you know, we were, it's time. We had people constantly asking us, you know, we're calling you to get these weights. Don't you have a website? And I was like, well, we don't have a business license yet, but we'll do it. You know, we're going to go get it. And then that night, Jamie said, you know, this is done. Go get a license. Let's open a website. Let's get it going.
But one thing we didn't want to do, we just didn't want to throw a product out there. First of all, I mean, this thing we wanted, when we throw a product out there, we wanted it to be something that we know that's going to work. And this thing that we, you know, Rebecca's the one that builds them. I just look good. I'm sorry. I just look good. She builds all these things and makes me look good. So, you know.
Look at
this
puppy.
But, you know, it's just.
Jackson's puppy is so cute.
Looks like she's swimming again.
I want a puppy.
But, yeah, Rebecca's the one that makes Carolina Lake Weights what it is, man. She puts in the hard work every day.
Bringing that puppy on up.
All right, buddy. Let's take
everybody. Our lab's out here sleeping on the floor.
She's out here snoring. Anytime she gets loud snoring, I put my foot on her. I'm like, stop.
That'll wake everybody up.
She's our little alarm clock.
That's not a sink there.
Oh, that's awesome. He's
up new. All right.
I look up, Chris is gone.
Yep, that's my life. Dealing with this thing.
Is he hanging on the roof?
All right, buddy. You gotta go.
It's a steering wheel.
Go this way so you don't hit the cords.
Are y'all fishing tomorrow, Ken and Alicia?
I don't know. What's tomorrow?
Thursday.
Oh, I don't even know anymore.
Ken looks like he's gone fishing already.
Oh, gosh. He wasn't supposed to fish last night. We had that last minute booking. So from what we know, we don't have anything tomorrow and we want to go fishing in the morning, but you never know.
Nice.
What about y'all, Jamie? You going to fish Friday night, or since you were going to fish a tournament?
No, we're going to have to work Friday, so I had to skip that tournament. But we will definitely be fishing Saturday night, so we might do a live. We don't know yet. Depends on where we go.
I'm still waiting on where you going. I haven't heard it yet.
We'll send you a video, buddy.
Yeah, we'll send you a video. We'll give you a fish report on Sunday.
I'm hoping we'll be doing this.
That's him holding up his thumb. Yeah, like that. There you go. See, Jamie, that's it.
Yeah, I got to learn it again. I got there we go.
Jamie was holding up his subway. It's like, what the heck?
I'm going to do a parade Saturday morning right here in the hometown. And then go catch some bait and go somewhere Saturday night.
Nice. Well, stay in touch and let us definitely know where you're going, man.
Yeah, I hear you. I hear you.
You never know about us.
I'm going to go fishing with Jesse Campbell. We're going to go try to catch some big gar.
Nice.
Ooh, I want to do that so bad.
We're going to go fish somewhere down on the East Trinity. So.
He's got a lot of hitting right now.
Man, I've seen some giants coming in, so hopefully we can get one or two.
We definitely got to try it out.
Yeah, Jesse got a 215-pounder last week.
Wow.
7-footer, man.
That's crazy.
I know it.
Ow.
Well, Jamie, man. I know you're not going to fly, but we drive.
Only if I drive.
No, we ain't doing that. Now.
He sleeps.
If she's driving, I still might fly because it might be safer. I love you too, honey.
I figured out a way to get him on a plane.
She finally figured out how to get me on a plane. Tell me she's going to drive.
You may have to knock him out.
Hey, flying's good. I was worried to start with, but I get on the plane, I go to sleep.
Within 5 minutes, I'm down.
Yeah, Jamie, it's not a big deal, man. Just do it.
That's what I heard. I don't know.
You feel about how I do when it comes to playing. I have never gotten on a plane.
I can picture Rebecca dragging me through my ankles through the runway or the
the runway.
Where you gonna get on the plane?
Look, he's got a bottle.
I don't even know what that thing's called.
He's going down the catwalk straight to the plane.
Straight getting fishing says he wants to thank Ken and Alicia for putting him on these weights. It saved him countless amounts of tackle and time and money.
That's right. That's what we want.
Thank y'all so much.
I don't think guys really understand when they see the weight, it looks like other weights that, you know, you've used. But if you really get to inspecting them, they are different than other weights that look similar. I've used pretty much every weight in the industry, and some of them work better than others, but none of them have worked as good for me as Carolina Lake Weights. Over the last 15 years for drifting and dragging, I average about 100 weights per year. I weekend fish. It's not like I fish 3 or 4 days a week. I weekend fish. But in a year, I go through about 100 rigs per year. This year, I went through 8 or 9. the whole year.
That's a big difference.
Eight or nine. So when you do the math and you're spending 12, you know, like me, I got a really fancy rig with my almost two, everything's expensive. The hook, the rattle. I use a Roscoe swivel. I use a scissor clip. I crimp. I use spacer beads. I use bumper beads. I use a sinker slide. When you add it all together, it's like $12 rig. And that's me tying it. You do the math on that, and it saved me over $1,000 just by putting a Carolina Lake Weight on there. I really don't know that there's another product that you can use on a boat that will save you as much money. They're that good. So kudos to you guys.
Well, that's y'all the story. That's what we like to hear, man. I mean, like I said, we definitely try. You know, we've done so much testing and stuff, and we were hoping and praying that everybody would enjoy them. And I can tell you, you know, like I said, we definitely don't just throw a product out there. We definitely try them out and work with them and, you know, definitely use them.
Well, that's like when I met y'all. Y'all called them drifting weights, but I'd never drifted before. And then I just started using them for anchor fishing in the stumps. I mean, they work great in the stumps.
They're awesome in it.
They come out of the stumps a lot easier than regular weights.
Yeah, guys are like, they're expensive. I'm like, well, fishing's expensive. Do you want to pay up front, or do you want to pay on the back end of losing all your stuff? And how much time, you know, for me, if you don't have rigs in the water, you're not catching fish. So, you know, when you're dragging, you know, I drag 8 to 10 rods, and when things go bad, they go really bad. So 8 rods hung up makes you want to go home. And Carolina Lake Weights, they'll all bury, and then one by one, they're coming back off. And I mean, to me, it's saving all that time on the water, and it's, you can't even put a price on that part of it, but the amount of fish that I probably caught is from switching and not having broken off and dealing with snags and all that is probably 25% more fish. That's probably on the low side. And our best day where we broke the lake record 2 times in one trip, my son broke it and I broke it. Luckily, his fish was bigger than mine. We were dragging a stump field, and my buddy next to us was dragging probably one of the most popular dragging weights. It's a stand-up stick. I won't say the name, but you guys probably all know who they are. And they broke off 11 times and left about a quarter of the way through the trip. He pulls up next to me, and he's like, Chris, I look before he even said anything. I said, I see y'all struggling, man. He's like, we've been hung up all morning. Oh. And we lost 11 rigs. And I'm not tying another one. And I said, he's like, how'd y'all do? He said, we got 2 fish. He said, how'd y'all do? So, well, we broke the lake record 2 times. We got a 72, a 69, and 340s, and a handful of 30s. And he was just blown away. I said, you might want to get you some of these Carolina Lake Weights. Because he had to leave. He couldn't fish in the stumps like we were. And I believe if we weren't using Carolina Lake Weights, we wouldn't have caught those fish. We wouldn't have even been in that location.
Well, I know I've watched Ken and Alicia for y'all fishing. You know, when you go live on Facebook and stuff, sometimes I'm like, how are they fishing today? Where are they at? You know, I love watching y'all guys, you know, go live and do your thing. I mean, just like Chris, you know, I watch where he's fishing. We're over here like, okay, God, where are they fishing at?
What did he drag over a fence?
You drug over a fence that time. And
that was our Rogers tournament. I was like, I know there's a fence out here on Lake Worth. I don't know exactly where it is, but my buddy said he's drug up barbed wire fence in his anchor. and it's right about where I was at, and every rod just went.
Literally, they were. Done.
And we were live on a tournament, and I'm thinking, oh shit. But one by one, they. Every rod came over the fence, and I was like, holy smokes. I've never hit a fence and not lost every rig. They just, you just lose your stuff when you hit those fence lines like that. So,
and Ken, y'all, some of the areas y'all fish, man, I mean, it looks,
it looks cool.
It looks cool. I won't say what we, you know, but I'll let you say, you know, but it's crazy watching y'all fishing.
Insane.
Yeah, we like fishing in some pretty thick stuff.
We do some maneuvering.
So last night I had I had some guys call me for a guided trip last minute, and they wanted a big fish and just a few, you know, small ones to keep. And I said, yeah, we can do that, and we'll go get one, you know, CPR on a big one. We can try it anyway. And yeah. And when we went, I said, you see that stuff over there? It was just a big old pile of junk. And they said, yeah. I said, we're going to go fish right there. and we did. And I literally pushed into it, got out of the boat onto the pile of rubble and tied us off to it. And we started casting all in it. And it wasn't 15 minutes later, and he caught a good one. But, yeah, we love fishing and stuff like that. And the weights definitely make a big, big difference. Without it, I ain't going to say I would never catch a fish, but it's a lot harder, a lot more difficult, and a lot more money involved when you don't just pay the money and get what you need to get in there and fish right off the bat, you know.
I know y'all were after a couple of nice fish, and y'all went back to the same spot a couple of times and tried to catch those fish that y'all were after, and I believe what y'all ended up finally, you know, catching those fish that y'all were after.
Yeah, that was actually a spot we had marked out right before the spawn, and they were staging in this area. So we thought that they were going to hang out there throughout the spawn, and which wasn't the case. They moved. But we went in there for a couple weeks in a row, and it was a couple of different fish. This is before Carolina Lake Weights, and Alicia missed a heartbreaker. I mean, it was unreal how big this fish was, but she missed it. It just wrapped around the tree, and it was over. And then
I pulled that tree up out of that lake, by the way. Go swimming.
I'm tired of it. She tied my rope to the boat and to that tree and jerked it out of there.
You go. I love it.
And then about 2 weeks later, my son, he hung into one, same exact area, same spot, and it did the same thing. It just ran to it, but it was multiple trees. Y'all can see it in the background. It's multiple trees. It just ran to the trees, and that was it. So we switched over. And I think I was on the oil rig still at the time. And the first day I came home, we tied those on. And then the first hour, right before dark, I caught a 52 in them sticks with no problem.
None.
And then after that, I think a few days later is when a guy booked a trip from Oklahoma. He came down. I took him into this same area after getting him on a few fish. And we moved in there. And he caught a 61 out of the area. And it no problem again. And that just, it saves you time and a lot of heartache too. So
good deal, man. Yeah, we definitely, you know, we love watching everybody fishing, and we'll go, you know, sometimes go into lives and just sit there and, you know, say, hey, because, you know, y'all guys, I mean, y'all been tearing them up. I mean, you know, y'all been just entertaining to watch, you know, and stuff. So we definitely appreciate y'all guys. We really do.
Y'all appreciate y'all.
Y'all definitely have put in the time and the effort, and y'all are killing it.
We got Josh in the house. Josh is another one of our pro staffers. He's a Nebraska Mad Catter.
What's up, y'all?
Rebecca's over here going, hey!
That's my buddy!
I miss you too, Rebecca. What's going on?
Ready for a pizza.
What's up, Josh? Where you been?
Not much. We had T-ball. Oldest T-ball. Girl had T-ball tonight, so we got done a little bit early, and everybody's like, hey, we're done 20 minutes early. Who wants to run another inning? It's like, why not? So, Eric, what's up, brother?
Eric, what's up, brother? Warrior Energy Drinks.
Welcome in, Eric.
There it is. What's up, Eric? Glad to have you, buddy.
So, Yeah. No, we've been playing with 6 and 7 year olds all night long, so it's been fun.
Nice.
So y'all sleep good tonight.
Yes.
When are you fishing, Josh? What you got? What's your plans, man?
I am taking a day of vacation Friday. So I just started a new job at our school. So I'm taking Friday off, and we're going to head up. We have our first two-day tournament at Calamus Reservoir in Burwell, Nebraska. It's another lake, just a lake tournament. We don't have many rivers around here. I'm 4 hours from the Missouri, so I don't get to fish that much. I'm more of a lake fisherman. So we got our first two-day event coming up Saturday and Sunday. So we're going to go up tomorrow night and start pre-fishing and pre-fish all day Friday and see if we can get on some white bass for some good fresh bait. See if we can put Carolina Lake Weights on the podium.
There you go, buddy. We just had, I guess, talking about our bald heads earlier.
The boys were showing their heads off earlier and straightening fishes. And another bald guy, y'all got to get a hair growth sponsor for the show.
So the only thing I hate about having little to no hair is I was mowing last week and I didn't have my watch on to tell me what the UV index was. And I just went to mowing like I usually do. I come home and my head hurt. My head was on fire. The next 3 days, just like peeling like crazy. It's like, man.
I know how you feel. That tournament last Saturday, we were not pre-fishing, but we were catching bait during the sun. And look, I'm still got roasted.
He's so beautiful.
I knew when I come home and I took my sunglasses off and I had the mask. I'm like, oh, this is gonna hurt.
that lotion does make your skin look shinier.
Gosh, there's Jamie's 30 minutes of beauty tips now.
Rebecca, shut the light off. Cover that.
Sorry.
You got to put on one of those fancy new Carolina Lake Weights hats.
There you go.
Yeah. Well, see, we're gonna hang some hair off of those hats. That way, it looks like.
I got
an
Amazon that thing.
Not only do they prevent or hide the glare, they prevent us from getting sunburned since we have no hair.
And I just put a top on the boat. Oh, it was on the boat, and I didn't even put it up because we were trying to, catch bait fish, and
no, JT went fishing with Jeremy, JTC, and they come home and they are. Chris, redder than your hat. I mean, and I'm like, why did you go put the top on? They're like, yeah, catch fish. Oh, my God. I felt so bad for them.
I hurt Sunday morning. I ain't gonna lie.
Oh, yeah. I hurt for a few days. And my oldest, she's got a weird thing. She likes to, like, peel your, like, when you get sunburned and you start peeling, she likes to peel it all off. She seen my head was peeling. She's like, I'm like, no. not there. That hurts. Like, she loves to peel your shoulders and your back of your arms and shit. It's like, not the head.
I always wear a hat when I fish, but this time of year, I take my shoes off for the first time. They're white as a ghost, and they just get freaking cooked like bacon. Yeah.
So you cook your socks?
Yeah, so yeah. I go barefoot on the boat, and, I'm just out fishing, You don't pay attention till the end of the day, and you're like, man, my feet feel like they're on fire. I look down, and they're just, like, blood red.
You don't feel it until the end of the day, and then it's like, crap.
It's weird you said it, because I wore flip-flops, actually, for the tournament, and catching bait for that tournament. And the top of my feet got burnt, except for where the logo is of the flip-flops. So now I've got crisscross and all kinds of mess on top of my feet. Well, they were like sandals. They were doing some crazy stuff.
You wear mushrooms? The crisscross? Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
No, you didn't.
I could tell.
So, Josh,
unfortunately, I don't have my cover. I won't have a cover for my boat till this winter. We only got a few people out here that will do these covers, and mine's old enough that I can't just go and order one. So I had to have a custom made.
How hot does it really get in freaking Nebraska? Come on,
dude,
man.
It does. It gets pretty brutal sometimes. July sucks.
Well, we're already into the 90s here in Texas. Our water, I think our north end of the lake's 83 degrees now. Our south end is already 78. Our north end fish are in full spawn. Our south end fish are ready. They'll probably be in full spawn by this weekend. Our big fish, you can still get one who's straggling. I see some. I mean, Ken got one, was last night or the night
before? Yeah, and the weird thing about that fish is it was in that 80-something degree water in the north end where most of them are already spawning or already done spawning. Some of them's already done. She called.
They don't all go off the same clock. That's for sure.
They don't.
But we haven't even started our spawn up here. Our water currently is about 68 degrees.
Kind of moved to Nebraska.
So we haven't even started our spawn yet.
Last weekend,
actually, our last tournament, we didn't even pull baits, and even this weekend, it's going to be questionable whether we pull or whether we anchor. But I mean, I love
last
pulling
weekend.
This lake.
I started dragging again, and we still had on the south end of the lake. The water temp was 76 in the main lake. So when I hit the lake, the threadfin were spawning. I mean, I went and the birds were lined up, and when I went and marked them, there's fish everywhere, and I just passed it. I'm like, I am sick of freaking anchoring. I'm going to go drag. I'm going to find them. There's got to be some fish that are getting into the summer pattern. So that's what I went and did. We ended up doing pretty good. We got one decent one. It was about a 27-pounder, and then my son, he broke another couple of records. Off a hybrid, it's like a 12-pound hybrid, and we catch some hybrids here and there, especially this time of year. They get really aggressive, but I've never seen one that big. The kid just got luck coursing through his veins. Wish I had a picture of that. Maybe I do.
What are you guys using to catch those hybrids down there?
I'm dragging for catfish, man. I was using. I caught that thing off of a whole sunfish. I was dragging around rocks thinking maybe I'll get one of these blue cats that's spawning around these rocks, get him excited to, you know, bluegill like rocks. So
yep.
When I'm around rocky stuff, I'll throw this bluegill around them. And we caught a bunch of fish. Most of them were 5 to 8 pounders, but we got the 27-pound blue, and then we got a 12-pound hybrid, and I got about a 5-pound hybrid. And that 12-pounder was crazy. I mean, it pulled like, you know, a 35-pound blue cat, but it was like running across everything. It was fun to be able to do something different. We've been anchoring for so long. I think we had one trip we drug up at Texoma where Jackson got the 80. Other than that, we've been anchoring every trip, and it just, I get tired of anchoring, man. I don't have power poles and all that, so it's a lot of work to throw those damn Texas box anchors. Get sick of it, and my legs so silted in, I got to clean them off every time I pull them in.
Yep.
Sucks.
It's heavy, too.
And my boat's big, so I use 27-pound box anchors. Man, they'll break your back.
I keep telling Rebecca about 3 and 4 o'clock in the morning after throwing that anchor all night in the tournament, I just want to throw it out and leave it. I'm done about 3 o'clock in the morning.
I got one of those. I got one of those brush grippers. You just hook on a limb.
Yeah, but you got to be around a limb.
Yeah.
Well, that's where I'm. That's where I'm a fish. I'm gonna throw all up in those trees, so I can break every rig off. Because that's where the fish is gonna be at.
Yeah. Well, Russell, when you normally ask, well, what are y'all doing about that time of night? And you see us kind of drifting by you. We're drifting.
Tired of pulling that anchor up, ain't it?
Yeah, we're anchoring.
So Ken and Alicia are gonna have to jump off. They gotta go get the kiddos ready for bed. So
yep. Mine just crawled out of the shower.
My son's been been running wild for an hour, so I'm afraid to walk into the house. I'm worried, afraid to walk into the house, see what I'm gonna see. But we appreciate y'all coming on, Ken and Alicia. We'll get y'all on here one night when we can just talk to y'all about all the cool stuff y'all are doing. Y'all, they've got a Ken's and Alicia. Ken's a guide. Alicia goes on the guide trips with him. Let me post. I've got a web link. Y'all can go over there and check them out. They also sell tackle, Carolina Lake Weights. Let's see here. ProfoundFishingTX.com. Hopefully I got that right.
You did.
Yeah, they can go on there and book trips or shop online. She's got a nationwide store on there now, so they can pick through thousands of different things in the inventory there. So it's pretty cool, and she put a lot of effort, a lot of hard work into it. I have no clue how to work it, but
I have to give a little credit to Desi too. She sat right there with me the whole time, helping with everything.
You can find Ken and Alicia on Facebook, Ken Ferguson, Alicia Ferguson. You can find Profound Fishing on Facebook. You can find them on their website. They're constantly catching big fish.
Oh, yeah.
And proud to have y'all as teammates. So thanks for coming on. Yes.
We appreciate it. And we had a good time.
Absolutely.
Good.
Thank y'all so much for everything. And if anybody out there hasn't, go check out. Definitely enjoy everything you see at Profound Fishing.
Thank y'all.
Thank you so much.
Have a good night.
Y'all too.
JBN said, LOL, if I anchor, we're there for a few hours.
What's up, Jaw?
I'll tell you what. If we're going to drag any lake this early in the year, I'm glad it's going to be this one. I mean, this one is our tree sanctuary. I mean, it's nothing but trees. They've actually got the lake, so it's a really oblong lake, and they actually have cut in half. This whole half is restricted to 5 mile an hour because there's so many trees.
Wow.
Yeah. So we're
do they have boating lanes?
Yeah.
Okay, yep. So you can drag those boating lanes. And I found that a lot of guys are like, you can't drag that lake. I'm like, you can drag the boating lane.
Yeah.
You know, as long as there's not, you have to be mindful of other boats, but right. Even in a boating lane, only guys that are blowing through there are bass boats. So occasionally you'll have somebody who's blows by you doing
even
something
in,
stupid.
So even in the lanes that they have cut for the boat, they still have it restricted to 5 mile an hour.
Yeah. Yeah. So you can say, hey, I got a line out. And if you see somebody coming, you can reel your stuff in, but.
Yep.
Those boating lanes can be great areas to drag.
Yeah.
Yep.
I use them a lot.
This is a fantastic lake. There's no blues in it. So it's going to be the most popular one in this one is channel cats. But this lake, our channels get just massive. I mean, we've had 34, 35-pound channels come out of this
lake. Dang. That 36, I think, that's about as big as they've ever caught in Texas.
Yeah, 34 is my personal record.
Wow. They just don't get that big down here.
Yeah, we caught one last weekend in the tournament, and I believe it was like 14 pounds, and that was big for us.
That's huge
for us. So we were, definitely proud of that one, man. But
oh yeah, but even those 15 pound channels, those suckers fight like crazy. I mean, they fight like a 40 pound blue sometimes.
That's it. That's it, man. That's it, Russell. Are you planning on going out this weekend?
Yeah.
You don't sound too happy about it.
I'm trying to figure out where some people that I know are going, but I don't know. Well, I'll figure it out.
I'm gonna sound like you're still losing gear. You sure you switched over to the Carolina Lake Weights?
Yeah,
we're going out. Probably going to lose some rigs.
I'm going to do a parade Saturday morning and then go catch some bait and get on the river.
There you go.
We might see you around. You never know.
So what? I missed the first half of the show. Jamie, what do y'all got going on?
Get your fingers in a cat's mouth. No, I do not. No, I'm taking those Carolina Lake Weights fish grippers, putting it in the mouth, and taking that Minotaur hook out and letting it roll.
Get out of here.
That's it.
Yeah, those channels, they get feisty, man.
Man, they run, they pull hard too. They pull so much harder than a blue cat or.
Oh yeah.
I mean, and they just got a lot more action when they pull than even like a flathead. Flathead's kind of a steady pull. A channel cat, hell, they like to get airborne like a dolphin sometimes.
Yeah, when that one last weekend hit that planer board, I mean, it just took it straight sideways. I was like, okay, this is gonna be a nice fish. And I was actually surprised at the size of that one. I was like, wow. This joker hit like a 50-pounder. So,
yeah. Now, I talked to Epic Catfish one night about it, and he was breaking down how the fish fight, you know, like the way they swim and swim differently. And he said that channels are the only ones that when they fight, they take their head the opposite way as their tail. Everybody else, they take their tail this way and they go like that. But channel cats go like, I mean, it's like they turn their whole body sideways when they turn.
I think not all fish fight the same. I can tell you from my experience of catching freaking thousands of big fish that you don't know really what you got until you see the fish. I've had, you know, we'll have a trip this winter. Like, we'll catch 840s on the trip and 250s, and then we'll catch a 30 that fights harder than all of them. I don't even understand how a 30 could fight harder than a 50. But I'm saying, oh, we got the lake record. This thing is just ripping drag straight down the back of the boat like it's just like you hooked a jet ski.
Yeah.
And I'm like, this is the biggest fish of the day right here. And usually you can tell, but occasionally out of a big fish day, there's one of them that's like doing something crazy that the rest of them don't do. So they don't all pull the same. And some of them give up real easy. Some of them surface 75 feet from the boat. But then some of them fight the entire way and they stay under the boat. They'll go around the boat three times. They try to break you off in the motor. They get up in your drift socks. They don't all fight the same. And you never know what you got till you're looking one in the eye.
I remember that morning myself and Rebecca, we hooked into a flathead during a tournament, and it was in the anchor. We're lifting the anchor. I mean, the pole's going. I mean, it was crazy. Around the motor, we were praying. I was like, wow. I mean, that flathead, I've never followed a flathead that was that aggressive. I mean, it was just like killing it.
Yeah. We went out Saturday and we hooked in. I'm assuming it's a flathead just by the way he took it, but we were fishing a inlet so that as the water drops in, those flatheads like to hide up against that wall. And then it comes down, the edges come, they taper, again, on the screen here, they taper down, and then it drops down into the bottom. And we were casting right on that edge, and we had one that just smacked it like a freight chain. And, I mean, we were right there. I got on that sucker, pulled it in a little bit, and that was it. He hung me up in them damn rocks so damn fast. And I mean, he never did let me bring him out of there. And I got patient, and I stuck the rod back in the rod holder, and we were just sitting there, it's like, I'll give you all night, buddy. I mean, I know what you're a good fish. I'll give you all night. He never freaking moved. Wow. So I'm assuming it was probably a big flathead because a channel there, usually they'll come out after a while, but he never moved all night.
Wow.
So, man. And then the real fun of trying to break that 80-pound braid.
That ain't fun. So JBN, we're gonna get JBN on the show soon. He's another Mad Cat teammate of me and Jamie. He's been friends with Jamie for a long time. He's the owner of New Slings. Josh got him a little partner here. He's the owner of New Slings. Really good dude. So we'll get him on the show soon, and that ought to be another interesting episode. So. Who do we got here, Josh?
This one. This is my oldest. This is Paisley. Paisley, say hi.
Hi.
And then this is our youngest. This is McKinley.
Hi, McKinley.
Can you say hi?
Hi.
Y'all out fish your dad, don't you?
This is Chris. This is Jamie. Rebecca's trying to hide off the camera. This is Russell.
Working.
Well, I tell you what, we're going to, like I said, we're looking forward for this weekend. I think things are going to be right. So, hopefully, we're going to catch some big fish.
We're sitting pretty good up here after having two weeks of tornado warnings. We're sitting pretty good for weather-wise this weekend.
All right, bye. Yeah, I hadn't had a chance to go over ours, but if everything goes right, this, I believe, the way things are going to go.
It looks right.
We should. The water, everything looks good for where we plan on going.
Right.
Discretion advice.
Saturday might be a little slow. So Sunday is going to be a pre-front. We got a storm that's supposed to be cooking in Monday. So Sunday is going to be a nice pre-front. So I'm hoping that Sunday will kind of heat up and start bringing on the big channels and the big flats.
I'm like that. Hopefully, we can get some new content and get some videos together and definitely get some stuff put together for YouTube and TikTok and Warrior Energy Drink. So, That's it.
That's probably it for tonight's show, guys. We'll thank the guests, Ken and Alicia Ferguson. Appreciate them coming on. Josh, thanks for coming in. Even though you're late, but that's, I get it. There's always kids stuff. Russell, appreciate you coming in, buddy. The other guys, I'm not sure what happened to them, but it is what it is. We'll get them back on at some point, but make sure you go over and subscribe to Nebraska Mad Catters on YouTube, Carolina Real Screamers. Make sure you go over there and give them a follow. Elgato Azul TV, if you haven't followed us, go over there and show us some support. We've got I think next week's guest is going to be Randy Carter from Minotaur Hooks, Hook Daddy. So that ought to be a fun show.
Yes, that'll be entertaining.
That should be a good one. So Jamie's been friends with him a long time. We're partners at Carolina Lake Weights. I'm on his field staff at Minotaur Hooks. Russell, are you on Minotaur?
He just added me to the pro staff last week.
So we're in that big triangle of Minotaur, Carolina Lake Weights, and Mad Cats. So I think this whole group here is pretty much somehow linked. Josh, you're a pro staff over at Minotaur as well, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm still in the group over there.
Okay, so we'll get him on next week. It ought to be a fun show. Appreciate everybody who's tuned in tonight, and we'll see you guys next Wednesday. We'll probably just keep this same time slot at 6:30. That's kind of our prime time. And we'll just try to keep getting better. Appreciate you guys stopping in, and we'll see you guys next week.
All right. Can you say bye, girl?
Bye.
So.